Hi, I'm Keith Bachman, Danfoss EMS Trainer. In today's video, we'll be discussing the initial logging in to the SM-800A unit. So we are with a brand new SM-800A unit that either came directly from the box or has been cleared. And when you do, you now have to go through multiple steps, 1 through 8, which we call pre-flight. The first screen that you come to will have these few questions on it, which is a bit about the agreement of terms and the privacy policy. So in order to proceed, it is necessary to go to these two boxes and check them. The next appears and we move forward. Now we'll have to go through each of these pages, the first one being language. So these are predefined pages that you have no option but to go through. The first one, as we see, is language and defaults to US, so we just continue. Okay, we're now on page 3, which will be for our login credentials. Now, this area is very important because when you enter this in, this is your only means of logging in until you go in under the configuration and make changes to it. So whatever you use here, it's extremely important that you keep note of it, write it down, so you have it available to you. If you do not remember this, then you will be required to go and request a new password, and that means you have to go through the official channels, and it could take time. So it's very important that you do this correctly and that you record your information. So the username can be anything that you choose. I will go ahead and just put something like test, just because we are working on a unit here, a mock-up of a unit here. So I put in test, and then when I go to the password, I now am required to follow these instructions here, which means I must be 8 characters. I have to have an uppercase and a lowercase, and I must have a digit that I'm using as well. I will go to capitals, and I'll put in, I'm just going to put my name in, K-E-I-T-H. And if you're not sure that you've hit your keys, as you can see, you can do the show, and now you can see exactly what you put in. I will go to my numbers. I'm going to go to the asterisk or the star, and I'm going to put it 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'll just do 5. So you can see I'm Keith with a capital K, asterisk 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I must repeat this because as most times when you log in, they want to make sure that you have the password as you want. So I will go and I'll put in a capital K, E-I-T-H. Go to my numbers, asterisk 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can see I have them both the same. I'm going to do next. So my login will be username as test, and my password will be Keith, asterisk 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're now on page 4, which is date and time. As you can see at the top, it's asking for the order or the format, which is month, day, year. It gives us the option of either being a 12 or 24 hour operation, and then we get to the date and time. And now when you're in here, this is at 11:05. This is correct for the date that I'm recording this, but you can see that I can, just by moving up and down, and I can go outside of that box to be able to rotate through the months. So there I'm on 5/5/20, but I have to start inside that box. I'll go up to the 11. And now I'm 11/5/2020. The time is 12:50. It is PM, but you can see I could switch to AM or PM. And once I've made those corrections, I do the save. The only other option on here would be your offset for your daylight saving time. I'm sorry, for your time zone, excuse me. And then we do next. Now we're on page 5. It wants to know the units. I could be PSI or bar. I can be degrees F, degrees C. Under light, I can be percentage, foot candles, or lux. Again, remember, it's a global product, so that's why these options are there. Now, on this screen, which is screen number 6, you can see that there are showing all the connection points, but notice there are a few in red, which indicates its future use. So this Ethernet connection on the outside here is for future use. Modbus 2 is for future use, and CAN bus is for future use. The current Ethernet connection is going to be right here, Ethernet number 0, and it resides inside underneath the cover plate. So this gives you an indication of where all the connections take place. Next, you're on the network, and if you're using things like DHCP, you would turn it on. You can see it's easy enough to turn it back off. Then we would be putting our manual IPs in just simply by clicking in the field, or touching in the field, host networks, external Ethernets, all your different options to allow for communications to be set up. And then when we finally go to the last page, page 8, notice that there are two check marks there. The system manager is currently up to date with the latest software version. That is correct, I am, so it's going to be please proceed, or please initiate the software update process after selecting finish. So the upgrading process, which will be done in another video, is an automated process for us, and we could check that and be able to do that. So I am correct there, I am current, I'm going to hit finish. And it's saying, okay, please verify that the initial setup is complete. Save your password in a safe place. Remember, we talked about that back a few slides. And we hit finish. Thank you for watching our video. And for more documentation and videos on the system manager, please visit danfoss.com/supermarket support.